Hello and welcome to this lecture of force vibration. In this lecture we will try to one problem of displacement transmissibility. What is transmissibility? If you are interested to understand in mathematical part of transmissibility, you can see my video on force and displacement transmissibility. In this session we are going to focus on a real life problem. So here I am showing that suppose there is a car moving in this direction, and to the car ahead to the car, the road profile is like a wavy profile which is having a certain known height as well as the known wavelength. Now if you are interested to find that what would be the response of this car, because I can make a mathematical model of this car by replacing the body or the weight of the car with a single mass, and then the tire and other suspension things can be considered as the spring and the damper part. So in this case, one of the way to make a mathematical model of this system to consider a mass M, and this section can be broken into a spring and dampered part. Similarly, the second part can also be considered as a spring and dampered part. And now if I am going to consider this model moving on this wavy road, what would be the response? So physically I can understand that there will be two types of response. One will be the complete up and down motion, so we call this kind of motion as the bouncing motion. Another motion will be the rotation about this point, so the second motion will be the pitching motion. So the system is going to have a pitching kind of motion as well as the bouncing kind of motion, and these two are the two independent motions, so your system will come under the category of a 2-degree of freedom system. So one of the way to represent this car as a model of 2-degree of freedom system, but in the current session we are talking about the single degree of freedom system. So the second option which we are having here is a single degree of freedom system model, is a simple mass with one spring and one damper moving on this wavy road. So in this case what will happen? So this is a category where we have the excitation coming from the base side. That means this is a case of base excitation or the displacement transmissibility. So my simple model will look like that. There is a mass M having a spring and the damper, and the base is having certain excitation, maybe like y is equal to y cos omega t, and because of that excitation of the base, my mass will move with certain amplitude x. So I can write that the x cos omega t minus phi. Why I am using this minus phi? Because I know when there is a damping, the two will not be in the same phase, there will be a phase difference. So my response can be written as x cos omega t minus phi. So in this lecture we are going to solve a problem of a car moving on a wavy surface, but instead of having this kind of thing, we are having numerical data. So here is the representation of my problem, that a single degree of freedom model of a car is shown here, which is moving with a velocity of v on this wavy road, and then the stiffness of this is given as 40 kilonewton, the damping is given, zeta is 0.1, this is the damping ratio. Y is given, y is what? Y is the peak to peak distance height of this wavy road, and which is given as 0.05 meter. In addition to that, it is also given that the peak to peak distance along the length, means this distance is also given, so this is given as 6 meter. So here the 6 meter is representing the wavelength of this path, and this y is representing the peak to peak height of the road. So that this road peak to peak height is 0.05. that means if I will represent this road with a wave like path, this height is the 0.05 by 2, because the total is 0.05, and this wavelength is given as 6 meter, and the vehicle is moving with velocity v. And in the question different cases are given. In one case it is given that you have to assume mass 600, velocity 10, 50 and 100 meter per second. Second case m 1000 and velocity 10, 50 and 600. That means there are total 6 cases. In one case I will assume mass 600 and I will assume different input velocities. Second case I can replace the mass with 1000, I can consider different velocities. But in this session I am going to explain you one case, and then you can extrapolate my methodology to solve the other cases. But I will try to explain you that how you can solve such problems. So in this case, where the roar profile is given in terms of peak to peak height as well as the its wavelength is given here. So what I will do here, now that I will make my mathematical model, this is my mathematical model where I am having an input value and an output response, and now I know that this is the case of displacement transmissibility. In that case, we know that if this is the condition, my x by y is defined by under root 1 plus 2 zeta r whole square divided by under root 1 minus r square whole square plus 2 zeta r square. So this is the formula for your displacement transmissibility which we have already derived. So I would request all the student that you should remember this formula. In addition to that, in that case we have already defined the response curve, which says that my response will start from one value, this is r and this is x by y. So my response will look like this way, and for all the damping value, my response value crosses from a single point which is having a value r is equal to root 2. This is also very important question for the different competitive exam, but I am not going to explain the theoretical part here. You can see my other video. Today we will talk about the numerical problem. So this is my numerical problem where all the data are given to me and now I have to get the solution. So as I know that this is the response formula, I know that y will be y cos omega t. Now in this formula, what are the unknown things? One unknown thing is the r value. R is omega by omega natural. Omega natural is given because I am assuming that mass is 600 and my k is given as a, what is the k value? My k value is given as 40 kilonewton. So my k is 40 kilonewton now, so I can get the natural frequency. But what will be the omega value? How I will calculate the omega? So if you will see carefully here, that if I will be able to get the time period of this vehicle crossing this one wavelength, that time period will this I will I know the velocity, I know the distance travel, so I will be able to get the time. Time will be what? Distance by velocity. I know velocity. I am assuming, suppose velocity is my 10 meter per second, I know this is the 6 meters, so my time will be what? 6 by 10. This is the time to cross this, and if I will inverse this time, I will get the excitation frequency. So here I am doing the same thing, that my vehicle is moving a distance of 6 meter with a certain velocity v. So my velocity, if my velocity is 10, my time will comes out at 0.6. as I will put this 0.6, I will get the omega. My omega is coming out 10.47 here, and my natural frequency is coming out 8.18. so when I will take the ratio of these two, my r will be omega by omega natural. My r is coming out 1.28. when I am going to put this r value here as well as the zeta value, I will be able to get this x by y, and y is nothing but 0.05 by 2. so ultimately I will get the response of my mass or response of my car. Similarly, so here I am putting the all the value in the formula, putting all this value, you will get this value. But you can see here that r is 1.28, and you know from the plot, when r will be 1.42, your transmissibility will equal to 1, and beyond that it will less than 1. But your r is what? 1.28. so your response will be in between these two values, means this your transmissibility is going to be greater than 1, means x will be more than y. So what will happen there? Physically, what is happening? If your velocity is 10 meter per second, and for that particularly you are getting a response of value which is more than 1, that means if there is a hole of 10 centimeter, you are going to experience this more than 10 centimeter if you are moving with a velocity of 10 meter per second. But if you are change your velocity, may be possible that your omega will more, and in that case your ratio will be more than 1.41, so your transmissibility will reduce to 1, so that if there is a 10 centimeter hole, it will be experienced less than 10 centimeter. So let's see the second case. In second case, suppose my velocity becomes 100. Still I am assuming that mass is 600, so my natural frequency will same, that would be what? That would be 8.81. so my natural frequency is again 8.81, but as velocity changes, the velocity changed, the distance traveled is 6 meter but velocity is 100, so my new time period will be 0.06. when I will calculate this omega using the 2 pi by t, I am getting my omega is coming out 104. So my r will be what? My r will be omega by omega natural, that is coming out 12.8. that means if I will see my plot, which says that the transmissibility will be 1 for a value of 1.41 and I am somewhere here, that means my transmissibility has reduced now. So when I will put all the value, my r will be 12.8 here, my zeta will remain same and that is 0.1. so when I will put all this value together, I will get a value x which will x by y, or I will get x which will be less than y. So in that way I am going to experience if the my whole coming in the pathway will be around 10 centimeter, I am going to experience less jerk or less displacement. In this way you can change the mass value as well as you can change the velocity value, and you can calculate the different response. At the same time, if please remember that if you are interested to find the response for a critical condition, critical condition means what? Critical condition means if you are moving with a velocity v and v is unknown to you, and you want to set your v in such a way that your transmissibility should be minimum or optimum, so you can consider that for that case, if r is equal to root 2, that means you are now at the verge, and beyond this r your transmissibility will further reduces. So for an optimum case, you can consider that if you want what should be the velocity of your vehicle so that your transmissibility become 1, that means r will be root 2. So in this case, if your excitation frequency is not given, you have to first calculate the excitation frequency and then you can calculate the r, and then you will find the transmissibility. On the other end, if r is given to you, you are going to put r here, you are going to put zeta here, and then you will find some value. So based on the given condition, you have to solve this complete numerical. Thank you.